The caption for this morning meditation is very simple. Blessed. Blessed. What does the word blessed means? In Tamil we use the word bhakyavan. Even in ordinary day-to-day language, ramba bhakyavan da, ramba bhakyavati. What do we mean by bhakyavan? Or we say blessed person. What do we mean by that? The literal meaning of that word blessed or bhakya means enviably happy. Enviably happy. Others don't take pity on us, others envy us. We are blessed in such a way. We are blessed in such a way, our family, our children, our profession, financially, physically, emotionally, intellectually, socially, the way we are placed, people will envy at us. We'll be happy in such a way that others could envy at us, enviably happy. That's the blessed life. What is a cursed life? When people take pity on us, when people feel sad for us, that's a cursed life. When we are enviably happy, when people envy at us, we have got a blessed life. So in the Bible, both in the New Testament and in the Old Testament, we see a number of verses how a person can be blessed. And in the book of Psalms, there are more than 23 verses. There are 23 verses which talk about blessed people. So I've just chosen 25 references from the Bible. How a person can have an enviably happy life on the earth. For you to have a happy life on the earth. So I can title it, Blessed in Psalms. From the book of Psalms. We go to chapter 32 verse 1. There we see two experiences. Number one. Blessed is he whose transgression is forgiven. If the Lord has forgiven our transgressions, what all the areas where we transgressed, mirudal, where we crossed the limits, knowingly or unknowingly. So may the Lord, if the Lord could forgive our transgressions, we are a blessed person. We don't ask for forgiveness. We don't know whether the Lord has forgiven our transgressions or not. We transgress many areas. And we don't feel sorry for the transgression we do. We justify our transgressions. We cannot have a blessed life. So you transgress the signal. Can you be happy when you are caught? When you transgress the signal, when you transgress the time limits in your office, can you be happy? When you transgress the life principles in your house, can you be happy? As long as there is transgression in you, whatever the reason you can give for transgression, you can't have a happy life. It's a stressful life. Similarly in the spiritual area, if the Lord could forgive our transgression, it's not even the sacrifices. They give a lot of sacrifices. But the desire is, I will be truly a blessed person if the Lord could forgive my transgression. In verse 1 again, the second point, point number 2. When my sin is covered, blessed is he whose sin is covered. It is not that we can't do anything to cover our sin from the sight of God. Sin is falling short of the glory of God. God created in his own image. When we fall short of the glory of God, that is sin. falling short of the glory of God, transgressing His laws, His principles, it's sin. With what I can cover my sin that God could not see it? It is only in His blood. Nothing can cover my sin from His sight. The blood of Jesus Christ can cover my sins. It means it washed away my sins. Then I shall be a blessed person. In verse 2, Psalm 32 verse 2, we see the third one. Blessed is the man unto whom the Lord imputeth no iniquity. Iniquity is doing everything that is against an order. கிரமத்துக்கு மாறாக செய்கிறது. கிரமத்துக்கு மாறாக செய்கிறது அக்கிரமம். Blessed is the man in whose is the man unto whom the Lord imputeth no iniquity. It doesn't mean that he just oversees all our iniquity. The spiritual meaning is he gives us grace that he will not say, okay, this is iniquity, this is iniquity. He can show no iniquity in us. He imputeth legally. He cannot find fault and iniquity in us. This is akrama. He said it akrama. அப்படின்னு அவர் சொல்றதுக்கு ஒண்ணுமே இல்லை. That person is a blessed person. So number 4, this is very, very important. Again 32 verse 2. Psalm 32 verse 2. Blessed is the man in whose spirit there is no guile. In whose spirit, not only in whose thought, not only in his mind, even in the spirit, there is no guile. There is no fraud. There is no deception. Very simple, very frank. Certainly that person is enviably happy. He has got nothing to hide. No guile is found in him. What he thinks in his heart, he speaks out. But there's a gentle spirit also. So in verse 1 and 2 of Psalm 32, we see four things. Our iniquities must be covered, nothing to impute against us. Our transgressions must be forgiven. Our sins must be washed away. And no guile should be found in our spirit, then we can be happy. We'll go to number 5. Psalm 112 verse 1. These are the small, small things where we can have an enviably happy, easy life. Psalm 112 verse 1. Praise ye the Lord. Hallelujah. Blessed is the man that feareth the Lord, that delighteth greatly in His commandments. Number 5. Blessed is the man that feareth the Lord. Blessed is not the man who was scared of the Lord, who was not scared of the Lord. He that feareth the Lord, it's love, a reverence, a desire not to offend the Lord. The philosophic meaning of fearing the Lord is always in every situation having the presence of God real. Lord is with me. Even when you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, a feeling, the Lord is with me. When a temptation comes at the house of Potiphar, a feeling, the Lord is with me. The Lord is with me. When I am in the prison, the feeling, the Lord is with me. When I cross the Red Sea, the feeling, the Lord is with me. So the is only not only at the house of Potiphar when the temptation comes. In every situation, to feel the awesome presence of God. That's the philosophic meaning of the word fearing the Lord. In my college, when I am with my friends, when I meddle with my social, when I talk with my friend, In every situation, if I could feel the presence of God close by my side, that is fearing the Lord. A desire not to offend Him. Three things are very important to understand what is fear of the Lord. One is, at all times, feeling the presence of God close by our side. Not only when we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, even when the temptation comes by our side, I know the Lord is with me. Number two, a desire not to offend Him. A desire not to offend Him. Fear of the Lord. Number three, again, always a desire to do what pleases Him. Avarku ishtam pa. Adhaan seiven. A desire to please Him. So we'll go to number six. Again, it's Psalm 112, verse 1. Blessed is the man that delighteth greatly in His commandments. In His commandments. To think about the commandments of the Lord, it's a joy. It's a joy. And in the New Testament, we are not under the law. But in the New Testament, we know that all the commandments are good. All the commandments are by the Lord. It's a New Testament experience, a delight in His commandments. Honor your parents, a delight. Bring all your tithes, it's a delight. Keep the Lord's Day holy, it's a delight. It's a delight. Reading the Bible, it's a delight. It is not keeping the commandments. Step number one, a delight to keep the commandments. A person who has got the delight to keep the commandments of the Lord, not considering them a burden upon burden, not considering a burden upon burden, but a joy to keep those commandments, he is really enviably happy. You can be enviably happy if you know to keep the commandments of the Lord. Number six, Psalm 112 verse 1 again. Oh, that we have finished. We go to the seventh one. Am I right? Am I going correct with the points? Seventh one. It's a very familiar one, Psalm 1 verses 1 and 2. Psalm 1 verses 1 and 2. Blessed is the man whose delight in the law of the Lord. There's a small difference between the commandments and the law of the Lord. Law of the Lord speaks about His principles. Ask and it shall be given. It's a law of the Lord. There's no commandment. Ask is not a commandment. Honor your parents, it's a commandment. Keep the Lord's Day holy is a commandment. Steal not, it's a commandment. Ask and it shall be given. It's a principle. It's a principle. If you keep all these commandments, His blessing shall follow. It's a principle. It's a law. It's a law. God abides by this law. The universe abides by His, as we go, the physical laws. The spiritual kingdom abides by His spiritual principles. You follow this principle, you'll be happy. So now the seventh one, not just His commandments, go and come. His laws, His Vedam. That Vedam is nothing but His principles. Why do we read Bible? We understand what God likes, what God doesn't like, what God can do, what God cannot do. There are things which God cannot do. There are things what God can do. What works in the spiritual? Prayer is a principle. Pray three times a day, pray five, seven times a day, pray without ceasing. It's not a commandment. When you pray, this happens. This is how it works in the spiritual realm. So we should understand what the difference between a commandment and law. And if you delight in the principles of God, As a child asked a question, why should we pray? It's a principle. If you eat only, you will get this. You have to eat, it's a principle. You have to drink this much of water, it's a principle, life principle. Similarly, for you to be happy, enviably happy in this world, jolly good fellow, to be enviably happy in this world, you must delight in His principle. His principle should not be a burden. His principle should not be a burden. Okay, just I delight in His principle, that alone cannot make me happy. I go to the 8th one. Again it is in verse 1 and 2 of Psalms 1. Psalm 1, verses 1 and 2 together. Blessed is the man who in his law doth meditate day and night. Not only I delight in His principles, in His laws, I meditate day and night. Two meanings. Meditate means thinking deeply on it. Okay. If I ask, it shall be done. Whatsoever I ask, He will do it. What's that I should ask? He will do whatsoever I ask. Then what's that I should ask? How should I ask? I should ask in faith. I should know that God can do it. So when I don't get it, what should I do? Meditate on His principle. Just I'm talking about the prayer alone. Not only prayer. Say, the Lord wants to bless me financially. What is the principle? But I cannot just think that I am putting it into, as I am giving it for interest. I am giving money to the Lord, then the Lord will return that money 30-fold, 60-fold, 100-fold. It's not that type of a calculation also. So we have to be very careful, extremely careful. How does it work in the spiritual area? In the physical area, sowing and reaping. What we sow, we reap. How does that work in the spiritual area? If I sow money, I may get money. If I sow time, I may get time. If I sow my talents, my grace, more grace. What did I sow, I reap. If I sow liberally, I reap liberally. If I sow sparingly, I reap sparingly. So I meditate. So one is thinking deeply, that's meditation. And the literal meaning of the meditation here, muttering. In Chennai Tamil, the beautiful way to say that, pinathrad. Once when I was struggling to explain what is muttering, immediately one Chennai sister helped me. Pinathrad. From that day I learned that word, pinathrad. You always talk about His principles. There's a problem for husbands, say, ask, God will do it. Ask, God will not, God will do it. Some misfortune. When you love God, all things work together for good to them that love Him. You're loving God. So this, don't see this as an individual piece, an isolated piece. All things work together for good. It's only an isolated piece, this misfortune. But don't see this as an isolated piece. All things work together for good. Pinatra, speak about His laws, His principles always in every situation. So meditate means think deeply. And an analytical approach. Think deeply. And number two, you go and mutter that. Speak about that. Glory be to the Lord's holy name. Let us go to number 9. Am I right? Am I right? Okay. Number 9. Psalm 119 verse 1. 119 verse 1. Psalm 119 verse 1. Blessed are the undefiled in the way, who walk in the law of the Lord. Blessed are the undefiled in the way. Uttama markam. Your lifestyle should not be a defiled one. You should not be defiled by the systems of the world. You should not be defiled by carnality. You should not be defiled by iniquities. Those are the few things what we read in the Bible which could defile a person. So we must have a life that is undefiled. How can that be undefiled when we walk in the law of the Lord? It is not only we are meditating on the law of the Lord, we are walking. We are walking in the law of the Lord. Our lifestyle is based on the principles of God. If the Bible says, honor the Sabbath, a few days back, a doctor phoned me. She was discussing this with me about the Sabbath. I was really able to see how much they are excited in their heart to obey the law of the Lord. They want to walk in the law of the Lord, in God's principle. It's not the type of commandments. They are not burdensome. This is the principle. Okay, I want to set one day for the Lord. Okay, what good? I'll walk in the law of the Lord, the principle of the Lord. The principle of the Lord. So when I borrow money, I work against the principle of faith. Okay, let come what me, as Sister Shanti was saying, let come what me. I will walk. I don't want to borrow. I want to exercise my faith. I want to exercise my faith. When I borrow, I exercise against my faith. God cannot do, this Marwari can help me, or this rich man can help me, or this brother can help me, this relative can help me. Maybe we think God will help me through this relative. But I don't see God will help us to borrow money through somebody. If the Lord wants that to take place, won't He give us the money? So we apply a God's principle, that is walking in the law. But we don't allow the world, the system of the world, the thoughts of the world, the philosophy of the world, or any carnality to defile us. Then we are happy people. Not only we are happy, we will be enviably happy. For us to be enviably happy, it is not necessary that we must have riches untold. It is not necessary we must have silver and gold. I don't have one, sister and I, we don't hold even 1 foot of land in this world. People with properties, I know how unhappy they are without 1 foot of land, 1 square feet of land, we are happy. We don't have 1 gram of gold with us. We don't have 1 gram of gold with us. Are we not happy? Not only we are happy, we are enviably happy. We are enviably happy. Others have got a type of envy at us. We don't have 1 foot of land on our name, neither sister nor I. My dear brother, my dear sister, to be enviably happy, it's not necessary you must have land and gold and silver. If it were some costly thing, we have got 2 silver tumblers with us, one of our believers presented. Probably that's the costliest thing what we have. Make life very happy. So here we see, blessed is the man who is not defiled in his way, but walk in the law of the Lord. 10, 128 verse 1, Psalm 128 verse 1. Blessed is everyone that feareth the Lord, that walketh in His way. We meditate on fearing the Lord, but now we see walking in His ways. It's very important. Walking in the law of the Lord, walking in the principle of the Lord, is different from walking in His ways. Let me tell you, walking in His commandments is different from walking in His law. That is different from walking in His way. See, the Bible says, just imagine, don't be equally yoked together with an unbeliever. It's a principle. It's a principle. Don't be yoked together equally with an unbeliever. It's a principle. It's a Bible principle. For us to be happy, for others to see that we have got a happy life. Just imagine that somebody loves a girl who is not, who doesn't have the same, or loves a boy. They don't have the same spiritual equilibrium. And after the marriage, she finds it. His ways are different. Now she cannot be happy. He may have a good job. But he wants to take baptism, she doesn't want to take baptism. She is a Hindu, she wants a Deepavali, he wants a Christmas. And the child is born, they don't know whether they must have Deepavali in their house, or Christmas in their house, or they must have both in their houses, or they don't have anything in their houses. They want to dedicate a house, whether they don't know whether they should bring the pusari, or they want to bring the father, or they want to bring the pastor. Their life is not very happy afterwards. Because they broke God's principle at one point. They broke God's principle at one point. Don't be unequally yoked together with an unbeliever. He is an unbeliever, she is an unbeliever. Separate yourself from an untoward generation. He is untoward to you. He loves to go to movie. You don't want to go to movie. You feel that seeing a movie is a great sin. He loves to take his wife to movie. You don't want to go to movie. He wants to go to pub. You don't want to go to pub. He is untoward to you. So living with an untoward person is very difficult. But now you are suffering because somewhere you broke God's principle in your life. Somewhere you broke God's principle in your life. Okay. When you walk in God's principle, your life can be happy. This is God's principle. Now what is God's way? What is God's way for me? What is the way that God has prepared for me? When I desire not to marry a person, an unbeliever, who is the person God has chosen for me? Who is that believer girl? Or who is that believer boy? And how should my marriage be? What type of a dress we must have? What is his way for me? It is not only his principle, every step I take, I've got a bell within me, this is the way, walk herein. The Bible says when I have to turn to the left or to the right, I hear within, this is the way. This is the way. This is how you should dress. This is how you must have a hairstyle. This is the dress you must buy for the bride. So not only his principle, the Bible says, the steps of the righteous are ordered by God. The steps of the righteous are ordered by God. There is a type of a, it is not only just fearing the, obeying the commandments of the Lord, not only meditating on God's principle. If you know for certain that you are walking in the way of the Lord, you are a blessed person. You are a blessed person. So I preach from the Bible, I preach the truth. Now I know that I preach what the Lord burdened me yesterday to share with you. That is the way of the Lord. My dear brother, my dear sister, more and more, more and more, more and more. When we walk in the way of the Lord, in every turn, I want to do the will of God. I want to be in the center of the will of God. Not only the will of God, the way of God. This is the way God wants me to go. This is how the Lord wants me to have my marriage. This is how the Lord wants me to build a house. This is how the Lord wants me to have my birthday party. If this is not how my friends want to have my birthday party. This is how the Lord wants me to have my birthday party. It's not what my relatives want to have it. We want to be enviably happy. If you want to be enviably happy, you must know the way of the Lord in your life. So the tenth point is very important. Blessed is everyone that feareth the Lord, that walketh in his way. 11. We go to Psalm 119 verse 2. Make a note. Psalm 119 verse 2. Blessed are they that keep his testimonies, his laws, his commandments. Now we go to his testimonies, Sachihal. There are a lot of testimonies. Just for this study, I want to make this testimony as 3 points. One is testimonies in the Bible. Testimonies in the Bible. They are not commandments. They are not law. They are not the ways. What happened in the life of Abraham? What happened in the life of Abraham? He is not a perfect model. We are not looking at Abraham and running our race. When we look into Abraham and run our race, at one point of time, Hagar will come in our life, Keturah will come in our life, we may make a lot of mistakes. See, Abraham is not our total model. We learn from the mistakes of Abraham. We learn from the faith of Abraham. We learn a lot of things from Abraham. His testimony. How he believed God. When he went to sacrifice God, what a tremendous faith he had. He was telling his servants, we will come back. Is it an ordinary statement, or he believed strongly that nothing would happen to Isaac, they would come back? A testimony of Abraham. How he believed in God. How was he able to renew his strength when his body was dead, when he had lost his potency? How he regained his potency? Sarah, a barren woman, and also lost her womanhood. How was she able to regain her womanhood? That pleasure. How was that possible? How did that work out in her life? I see his testimonies. It teaches some lesson to me. The life of Jacob. A situation came, he ran away from his parents. Father, mother, brother, everybody. Running to a place he never knew. In the wilderness, God gave him a promise that he would bring him back. Different things happened in his life. But as God said, God brought him back. I see his testimony in the New Testament. What God can do, what God did. How Samson erred. What that we can learn from the story of Samson. What we can learn from the story of Peter or Paul or Timothy are the saints in the history, their testimonies. What the Lord can do with David Livingstone or Hudson Taylor, Adoniram Judson, their faith life, their prayer life, we learn from that. We learn from their testimonies. That's one thing. Number two, the testimonies that we hear in the church, the testimonies we hear in our days, what the Lord has done in the life of so-and-so. In the church we hear testimonies. The Lord can do in their life, the Lord can do it in my life. There's a beautiful song we used to sing, it's no secret what God can do, it's no secret what God can do. What He has done for others, He'll do for me. What He has done for others, He will do for me. In our church there are many living testimonies. There are many living testimonies. How the Lord bless them, use them, even after they are diagnosed for fourth degree cancer in our church. So the Lord can do it in the life of so-and-so, God can do it in my life. We hear testimonies, many miracles, how the Lord blessed the fruit of the womb, how the prayers are answered. Hear testimonies. So number one, testimonies in the Bible. Number two, testimonies we hear about. The lives of the saints and the lives of other believers. And number three, what the Lord has done in our life, in the past. There are also testimonies. The Bible and the wrapper we see Parisutta Vedakam. But I don't see the phrase Parisutta Vedakamam, Holy Bible, in the Bible. But in many places it is said it's a book of testimony, Sakshi Nagamam. What God did in the life of Moses, what God did in the life of Abraham, how did God use John the Baptist, or the life of Paul, a chief sinner, is a book of testimonies. Your Lord can do that in the life of Paul, God can do it in anybody else's life. Your Lord can use Peter, the Lord can use me. So it's very, very important. Blessed are they that keep the testimonies. Learn a lot of things from the testimonies. Let me go to number 12 very quickly. That in verse 2 again, Psalm 119 verse 2. Blessed are they that seek Him with the whole heart. When you heard these testimonies, when you know the Lord can do this, the life of Abraham or the life of Joseph, in the life of Matthew, in the life of somebody else, or in history, or in your church, or in your personal life, now, you have got a grace to seek God with your whole heart. The Lord, you have done this miracle in His life. You can also do this miracle in my life. Lord, do it. With whole heart. Whether He will do it for me or not, it is left with Him. He is omnipotent, omniscient. He has got His own intelligence. He has got His own plans. But I know He can do it. So I seek Him yearly. They that seek Him yearly, it's not early morning, the first. A woman was suffering from hemorrhage for 12 long years. Then she sought the Lord. Why should you suffer 12 long years? Had she sought the Lord earlier, wholeheartedly, she need not have suffered for these 12 long years. So seek the Lord with prayer, with fasting. Lord, You must give me an answer. You must speak to me. You must show me the way. You must tell me what I should do. I seek the Lord. Seek the Lord and His kingdom. Seek Him early. You shall live. Kartare thedugiravargal pilaippargal. You'll have the right direction. So God should forgive our iniquities, God should forgive our sin, God should not impute, God should forgive transgressions, God should not cover your sin, God should not impute any iniquity on you. In your heart there should not be any guile. You must know God's commandments, you must know God's ways, you must meditate on God's principles, and you must keep God's testimonies. And when you know all those things in all your situations, without seeking the help of your mom, your dad, anybody else, seek the Lord, you shall find Him. You shall find Him. He will give you the guidance, He will give you the direction. So number 12 is very, very important. Blessed are they that seek Him with whole heart, not with a divided heart. இப்போ ஜோம் பண்ணி பார்க்கலாம், கெட்ச கிடைக்கட்டும், கிடைக்கலன்னு மார்வாரியை பார்த்துடலாம். ஸோ அவர் ஹோல் ஹார்ட் இஸ் நாட் வித் த லார்ட். இஃப் த லார்ட் இஸ் கோ டு தட் ஃபினான்ஷியல், இஃப் த லார்ட் கிவ்ஸ் அ டைரக்ஷன், இஃப் த லார்ட் ஹஸ் கட் அ பிளான் டு பிளஸ் யூ த்ரூ தட் பர்சன், திட்ஸ் அ டிஃப்ரெண்ட் திங். ஐம் நாட் ஹியர் டு பிளேம் எனிபடி ஃபார் எனி திங், பட் இட்ஸ் அ வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் திங். ஆர் யூ லெட் பை த லார்ட், ஆர் யூ லெட் பை த ஃப்ளஷ், ஆர் ஈவன் ஆர் யூ லெட் பை தி டெவில் to get into the snare. Now your feet are in snare. You lost your joy, you lost your peace, you lost your happiness, you lost your prayer, you lost your praising. No joy of the Holy Ghost. Only ashes. Instead of gladness, you've got a spirit of grievousness. All because we don't seek the Lord. You don't seek His guidance. So how, I mean, with the grace of God, all the thoughts what the Lord has given me, I put them in a sequence so that we can easily remember. Our iniquities, our sins, our transgressions must be dealt with, and no guile should be in our spirit. Then we think about His commandments, His laws, His testimonies, and we walk in His ways. And in every situation we seek Him. We'll go to point number 13. Psalm 2 verse 12. Psalm 2 verse 12. Kiss the Son, lest He be angry, and you perish from the way, when His wrath is kindled but a little. Blessed are all that put their trust in Him. Blessed are all that put His trust, their trust in Him. It is not only put their trust, the literal meaning is who cling on to the Lord. அவரை அண்டி கொள்ளுகிறவர். So when you seek the Lord, cling on to Him. The literal meaning is trust is different. Here is not trust in the original. அவரை அண்டி கொள்ளுகிறவர்கள் பாக்கியவர். ஆண்டவரே உம்மை தவிர எனக்கு வேற வழி இல்லை. நீர் காப்பாத்தினா உண்டு, இல்லைன்னா தொலைஞ்ச. யூ வில் பி என்வியபிளி ஹாப்பி இஃப் யூ கிளிங் ஆன் டு த லார்ட். டு சேவ் டைம் லெட் மீ கோ லிட்டில் ஃபாஸ்ட். நம்பர் 14, நம்பர் 14, சாம் 34 வர்ஸ் 8. சாம் 34 வர்ஸ் 8. ஓ டேஸ்ட் அண்ட் சீ தட் த லார்ட் இஸ் குட். பிளெஸ்ட் இஸ் த மேன் தட் ட்ரஸ்டத் ஹிம். ஜஸ்ட் மேக் அ நோட் ஆஃப் தீஸ் வர்சஸ். Psalm 40 verse 4, Psalm 84 verse 12. Trusting the Lord in all dire situations. When you cling on to Him, trust Him, He will not leave you. He will not forsake you. When all doors, it's a prophecy to somebody, when all doors are closed, Urishanamalaba, when there is no way out, God can open up a way for you. Where there seems no way, oh, the Spirit of the Lord is speaking to you. Trust Him. Trust Him. So to save time, Psalm 34 verse 8, Psalm 40 verse 4, Psalm 84 verse 12. Go home and meditate on His trust on the Lord. O Lord of hosts, blessed is the man that trusteth in Thee. Psalm 84 verse 12. I'll go to 15. Psalm 146 verse 5. Happy, the virgin is blessed. Blessed is he that hath God of Jacob for his help, whose help is in the Lord his God. When you take God of Jacob your partner, now you trust him. Lord, I trust you. Now you take him your partner. Work with him. Go with him. Lord, I need your help. I need your assistance. You have to share the burden with me. Our sins are forgiven. We walk in his law, his principles. We seek him. We cling on to him. We trust him. Say, I'm developing it step by step. All the verses that the Lord showed me from the book of Psalms. Now what I do, I want his help. He will not help as a servant, he will help as a king, as the Lord. He will help me. Not as a servant, not as a broker, but he will help me as a mighty man, as a mighty king. He will help me. When you cling on to him, number 15, he will help you. Number 16, Psalm 65 verse 4. Blessed is the man whom thou chosest and causest to approach unto thee, that he may dwell in the courts. We shall be satisfied with the goodness of thy house, even of the holy temple. When you take God as your help, you must try to live in his courts, in his presence. In his presence, especially in the church fellowship. Not only keeping God in your heart, not only seeking the Lord in your dire situations, your desire to be in the presence of God. Okay, I attended the morning service, it is enough. For the glory of the Lord, I tell you. Heard Sister Shanti's testimony. She doesn't know what that I got today for the message. I don't know what she was going to share the testimony. But this is the God's message to everybody. Desire the courts of the Lord. The presence of the Lord. The worship of the Lord. Going to the temple. Going to the church fellowship. Morning, evening, English service, Tamil service. Bible study, prayer meeting. Why your life is not blessed? Not to speak about Shanti. She said, I don't miss any prayer meeting. Coming from a Hindu background, educated, did a CA, in all situations, a desire in the courts of the Lord. She is blessed. Loneliness came. Sickness came. Tempest blew against her. How is that? That is the strength. That's what we read here. Goodness of thy house. Satisfied with the goodness of thy house. Even of thy holy temple. The desire to go to the courts of the Lord. Number 17, it is a little more deeper, Psalm 84 verse 4. Now he says, blessed are they that dwell in thy house. They will be still praising thee. It is not only in the courts, in the house. He talks about the servants of God there. In the Old Testament, even King David can go only up to the court. But those who get into the holy place and in the most holy place, they are the priests. He says, blessed are they that minister unto the Lord. They'll be praising you in your presence. So not only desiring to come to the church, being an active part, being in the service, those who do something for the Lord, they will be still praising thee. You are coming to the court, they will be satisfied with the goodness of the house, even the temple of the Lord. But those who dwell in the house of the Lord, what a great blessing it is. My dear brother, my dear sister, some of you come once in a week. Some of you may come twice in a week. There are some people here, they come every day to the church. Hallelujah! How much they are blessed. They come every day to the church. Not only for work, some come every day for prayer also. Life can be a blessed one when you serve the Lord. To save time, let me go a little fast. Go to verse 18. Psalm 84 verse 5. Psalm 84 verse 5. Blessed is the man whose strength is in thee. Now my sins are forgiven, iniquities, transgressions, etc. No guile is found in me. I love his laws, his commandments, his principles, his ways. Then I seek him. I walk in his ways. I cling on to him. I trust him. I take him for my help. I desire his courts, not only desire his courts, I want to dwell, stay in permanently in his house. And now my strength is not my education. I am broken. My strength is not my physical strength. I am broken. My strength is not my finance. That is broken. My strength is not my intelligence. That is broken. Hallelujah, the Lord is my strength. If you take the Lord as your strength, you will be enviably happy in this world. You take money as your strength, you take your relatives as your strength, you take your friends as your strength, at one point of time you would feel miserably weak. You won't have a life that others will envy at you. You will have a life others will pity at you. So to have a life that others could envy at you, you must take the Lord your strength. My strength is the Lord. Verse 19, Psalm 84 verse 5, the same verse. Blessed are them in whose heart are the ways of them. The literal meaning, blessed are them in whose heart are the highways to Zion in their heart. Unnathathukku thondum paadai en manasla irukku innum holy. I must go to Zion. I must reach heaven. The way to heaven is in my heart. I come into the courts, I dwell in his house, I take the Lord my strength. Now the ways to heaven is in my heart. Psalm 106 verse 3, point number 20. Blessed are they that keep judgment. Now I come to, when the highways to heaven are in my heart, I keep his judgments. What is right for him is right for me. What is wrong for him is wrong for me. How he judges things, I judge. I keep his judgment. I don't think his judgment is right or wrong. His judgment is my judgment. I judge things. I make a discretion. If it is right for him, it is right for me. It is wrong for him, it is wrong for me. I keep his judgments. 21, same verse, 106 verse 3. Blessed is he that doeth righteousness at all times. When I make a right judgment, this is right for him, then it's right for me. When I make a right judgment, I do right things. Righteousness is doing right things. What is right for him is right for me, that's judgment. Then I do righteous things at all times. In my house, in my job, in my ministry, in the school, church, I do righteous things at all times. 22. Psalm 41 verse 1. Blessed is he that considereth the poor. Now, I go to the next segment. I consider the poor. The poor is not financially poor, the underprivileged. Those have got a weakness. Is not financially poor, the underprivileged. Blessed is he that considereth the poor. The Lord will deliver him in time of trouble. If you have got this consideration for the underprivileged, the Lord will deliver you. 94:12. Blessed is the man whom thou chastenest. Andavare neer yare sutchikiriro avan bhakyavan. Sutchikiradengirathu literal meaning when the Lord disciplines. When the Lord disciplines my going. If I do something wrong, Lord, just give one coat to Lord. Don't, he will not chastise you that we will be totally destroyed. He will discipline us. He will discipline us. You know what does that word discipline means? The word discipline, the simple the meaning, I just explain it quickly. How many of you take part in the tracks event? 100 meters, 200, anybody here? Only Joe, sister, Amber, nobody else. You don't run. Okay, you find it difficult to walk, where to run, Pastor? Rolling? At least those who can't run, try rolling. So there are the tracks for 100 meter dash or 200 or half step and jump, hurdles. There are tracks. That is literally called discipline. You cannot cut the track. You have to stand behind the starting line. Only when they say go, you have to go. You, the first one to cross the finishing line, touching the finishing line. When you're running, you should not touch the track. That track is called discipline. From discipline, we get the discipleship, disciple. A border. So the sitchai is to make us run within our tracks. Make us run within our tracks. Not to break any rules. In hockey, we should not kick the ball. In football, we should not touch the ball. There's the discipline. There's the discipline. If we can kick the ball in football, can't we kick the ball in hockey? No, no. The goalkeeper can kick the ball. Why goalkeeper alone can kick the ball? That's the discipline. When you kick the ball in hockey, it is foul. That's foul. When you touch the ball with your hand, it's a foul in football. In hockey, when the ball is above your shoulder, you can touch the ball. Why it is so cumbersome? No, that is the discipline. They'll give a yellow card, red card. Why? That's a discipline. So when God disciplines us, make us run in the course that He has appointed for us, we are blessed people when God doesn't discipline us. A life without discipline, sad. And 24 verse 12. Psalm 94 verse 12. Blessed is the man whom the Lord teaches him out of thy law. When he disciplines us, in the same verse, he teaches us out of his law. See, this is my law. If you pray, this will happen. When you don't pray, this will not happen. So he chastises me and teaches me out of his law. I am a blessed person. I will have a life that is enviably happy. And lastly, Psalm 127. Make a note, Psalm 127 from verse 3 to 5. Psalm 127 from verse 3 to 5. Lo, children are the heritage of the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is his reward. As arrows are in the hand of a mighty man, So the children of the youth, so the children of the youth, happy is the man, blessed is the man that hath his skewer full of them, that hath his skewer full of them. They shall not be ashamed, but they shall speak with the enemies in the gate. One who is blessed with many children, he is a happy person in the world. When the quiver is full of arrows, the quiver is full of arrows, if he is with full of children, he is a blessed person. What we think, we should not have children. One is enough. For some people, two. I know one doctor family, doctor's wife, they're very old, they are no more. Till her death, one big worry she had, one big sadness she had. She said, God didn't give me this. What is that? God gave me only 15 children. 16th, 16 kathar kudukama vittara. 16 kathar kudukama vittara. One of Joe's friend, his wife, in her house, 23 children, am I right, Joe? 23 children. See, every night she has to take the attendance whether everybody has come home or not. Her quiver was full of arrows. Happy is that person, the Bible says. It is not only spiritually speaking, not only but literally, they are really a blessing. Our children are the heritage of the Lord. The fruit of the womb is from the Lord. It's a great blessing. When the Lord could bless your children, your sons, your daughters, they are a real blessing to you. And in a spiritual sense, you may be a teacher, or you teach in the Sunday school, or you pastor, or a youth leader, you've got many children. Even blessed is the one who is barren. Her children are many. Her children are many. You are not married, or you don't have a child, you are a barren. Blessed you are. Your children are many. When you do the ministry for the Lord, when you serve the Lord, I can give a number of testimonies. Just a couple of days back, a daughter of a servant of God. Now she's doing a wonderful ministry with her husband. Now when I met her, she was telling me in front of her father, "Uncle, the values that you put in our life." Probably she was my early Sunday school student. Those who were in my Sunday school, those who received the Holy Spirit in my ministry, through my ministry, they are doing international ministry today. What a great joy it is. Our children are many. Blessed people. They are willing to do anything. Once I was standing in a queue. I don't want to mention it. A very long queue to honor a departed saint. And there, the key person, he saw me in the queue. Immediately sent somebody, call him. My dear brother, my dear sister, my students, believers in the church. Yesterday we were able to have a wonderful party. The place was well arranged. We had a very good spread of breakfast, as usual in our church. See, one of the participants, he said, "Oh, I don't know whether I come into a church or to a MCC board meeting." MCC board meeting means Madras Cricket Club board meeting. How could that be possible? It's because of the children the Lord has given me. The Lord has blessed us with our children of our womb. The Lord has blessed us with many people in the ministry. I can go on and on and on with my testimonies, what, how the Lord has blessed us with children. Once a pastor is going to be dedicated for a very big church ministry. I was one of the invitees. One pastor was preaching, one pastor was doing the dedication in their mission, their organization, Assemblies of God. I was just sitting at the back. Then somebody called me, no, you should come front. And the pastor was conducting, when the dedication prayer was to be done, he was to do the dedication ordination service. It is a protocol of that organization. But he said, Pastor Robert Simon will ordain them. I was broken into tears. You know why? When that girl was in school or something, she received the Holy Spirit in my meeting. And when I was in ACA, he was my Sunday school student. Now they have come to the ministry. Both were in my Sunday school. Many years back, at the beginning of my ministry, my salvation, she received the Holy Spirit in my meeting. Later when I came to ACA, when I was in ACA as a believer, this pastor was my Sunday school student. And when the ordination time came, it is not the pastor. God made it so that I was to ordain both of them for the ministry. So when you serve the Lord, be a Sunday school teacher. Be a youth leader. Be a soul winner. Do the ministry for the Lord. When your quiver is full of arrows, you can speak to the enemy at the gate. Abba, mela varada, enna enakku avula strength irukku. Pullinga avula vera engoda nikkiranda, po po avanga valiya paathu po. I need not fight with my enemy, I can speak with my enemy. What a beautiful verse it is. Have you got, can you say that your quiver is full of arrows? Your quiver is full of arrows. But mine is very little. There are saints who yearn thousands, lakhs of people for the Lord. Lakhs of people for the Lord. My dear brother, my dear sister, I've taken a few more minutes extra, but the Spirit of the Lord has spoken to you. It's a very wonderful thing. Just meditate on the book of Psalms. You can have a blessed life in this world. Walk in His testimonies. Cling on to the Lord. Have desire in the courts of the Lord. Try to dwell in the house of the Lord. Let His testimonies be in your life. Fear the Lord always. Above everything, serve the Lord. Let your quiver be full of arrows. You are a blessed person. Shall we pray? We'll pray that the Lord will grant unto us this blessed life, a life that we would be enviably happy. I pray for you. Dear Father God, we thank you, we praise you, we worship you for the wonderful message you have given to your children. Lord, help us to have a blessed life in this world, O Lord. A life that maybe enviably we are happy. Lord, we need not be sorrowful that others take pity on us. In all your weaknesses, let your strength be made. In your name, I pronounce your blessings upon these dear brothers and sisters. Lord, let their quivers be full of arrows, that they can talk with their enemies at the gate, O Lord. Thank you for the wonderful message you have given to your people. Help everyone back, go back home with these heavenly benedictions. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.